Hey, it's Sizzling Popcorn, and here we make flight simulation fun and easy. Today we're going to explore the Fenix A320 family and guide you through setting up the MCDU, the MCDU, which is the aircraft's main navigation computer. If you're new to flight simming, don't worry. We'll break down each step so you can follow along with confidence. And by the end of this video, you'll know how to import your OFP from SimBrief into the EFB, load passengers and fuel, manage your flight plan, handle wind data for climb and descent, and even calculate your V-speeds using the Fenix EFB. So let's dive in. Before we initialize the MCDU, let's ensure that your navigation data is current. The nav data is essentially the aircraft's database of waypoints, airways, and other critical flight information. If your nav data is outdated, you might encounter discrepancies between your flight plan and what the aircraft expects, leading to potential issues during your flight. To check this, start by clicking on the MCDU menu button, then click FMGC from the list. You'll see the current nav data displayed on the screen. Make sure the date range is current. If it's not, you'll need to update it before proceeding. Now let's initialize the MCDU by importing your flight plan from SimBrief. When you begin this step, make sure that the FLT NBR, so that's your flight number, or from to fields, are filled in on the init A page. If these fields are left blank, the MCDU might default to the last OFP loaded into SimBrief, which could result in incorrect data being used for your current flight. By entering your specific flight details, you ensure that the correct flight plan is loaded. Once you've confirmed or entered this information, proceed by selecting init requests. This will automatically populate the departure and arrival airports, along with your flight number, cost index, and cruise flight level and temperature. That's your CRZFL/temp. Double check that these values match your OFP. The cost index is particularly important as it determines the speed and fuel efficiency of your flight. To ensure that your climb and descent is smooth and fuel efficient, you'll want to upload the forecasted wind data for the climb and descent phase. This data helps the aircraft's computer adjust its climb descent profile based on real-time wind conditions. On the init page, click on wind, then select wind requests. The MCDU will download the wind data for both your climb and descent. After the data is loaded, click on uplink insert to accept and apply both the climb and descent winds. With the initial data entered, it's time to align the IRS, or the inertial reference system. This system ensures the aircraft knows its precise position throughout the flight. To do this, go back to the init page and select IRS init. If you see nothing under IRS 1, IRS 2, or IRS 3, it means the IRS needs to be aligned manually. To align the IRS, head to the overhead panel and turn the IRS switches to align. Start with the first one, IRS 1, followed by IRS 3 and IRS 2. Once the IRS begins aligning, the MCDU will indicate this by showing IRS 1 aligning on GPS. Same thing for 2 and 3. When you do see this, click the blue Align on Ref button, then confirm by selecting the yellow Confirm Align. This ensures the IRS is correctly aligned with GPS data, allowing for accurate navigation throughout the flight. With the IRS aligned, let's import our operational flight plan, our OFP, from SimBrief into the EFB. And the EFB is your electronic flight bag, also known as the tablet. And those can be found on each side. So the captain has one on the left side by the window, and the first officer on the right side by the window. The OFP is a comprehensive document that includes all the essential details for your flight, such as the route, fuel, weights, and performance data. Importing it into the EFB not only helps with performance calculations, but also streamlines the entire flight preparation process. To import the OFP, open the EFB, your tablet, and go to the SimBrief integration tab. That is the homepage. You'll see an option to import from SimBrief. Select this and the EFB will automatically pull in all the relevant data from your OFP. This includes everything you need to accurately calculate your aircraft's performance and load configuration. Now that the OFP, your flight plan, is imported, it's time to load the passengers and fuel on board. This is an essential step in preparing your aircraft for departure, and the Fenix EFB makes it easy. So we're going to go navigate to the mass and balance tab on the tablet. Here you'll see options to load passengers, cargo, and fuel. Click on load aircraft. You can choose how quickly this is done, whether instantly or in real time, depending on how immersive you want your simulation experience to be. After the loading process is complete, you'll want to sync this data with the MCDU. To do this, click Send to MCDU in the EFB. This action sends the passenger and fuel data directly to the MCDU, ensuring that both systems are in sync. Next, we'll go back to the MCDU, click on Fuel Pred to verify that your ZFW, your zero fuel weight, and your ZFWCG, which is your zero fuel weight center of gravity, match what's shown on your OFP, your flight plan, and the EFB's mass and balance tab. If there's a significant discrepancy, you can manually enter the numbers into the MCDU, but keep in mind that slight differences may occur as fuel is currently being used. Now that the IRS is aligned and the aircraft is loaded, let's review the flight plan. This step ensures that all waypoints, airways, and procedures match your OFP. Now on the MCDU, we're going to click on the flight plan page, the FPLN page, and here you'll see your departure and arrival airports, along with all the waypoints in between. We need to set the departure runway and SID, or the standard instrument departure. The SID is like a set of instructions that guides your aircraft safely from the airport to the en route phase of your flight. To do this, click on your departure airport and then select departure. Choose the runway and SID that match your SimBrief plan or what you've been cleared for by ATC. Don't worry if it seems a bit tricky. With practice, it'll become second nature. For your arrival, you'll do the same thing by selecting your STAR, approach, and landing runway. The STAR or standard terminal arrival route helps your aircraft transition from the cruise phase to landing. Think of it as a set of instructions for safely descending and approaching the airport. Now, what if you need to change a waypoint during the flight? Maybe air traffic control gives you a direct routing, or you realize you need to skip a waypoint for some reason. No problem. Let me show you how. There's a couple of ways of doing this. The first one, and probably the most easiest and straightforward one, is using the DIR, the direct to button, which I didn't model here. But once you click on that, then you can choose the waypoint you want to go directly to, and then it will then continue on with your flight plan after that. You can also do it within the flight plan button. So click the flight plan button, and then you can choose the waypoint that you want to change the next waypoint after it. So you'll click on that. In here, you'll then click on next waypoint. That's where you'll put the next waypoint. Now let's talk about something you might encounter while setting up your flight plan, discontinuities. A discontinuity is a gap in your flight plan. It's like a break in the chain of waypoints. You'll see it marked as discontinuity on your MCDU. Discontinuities can happen for a few reasons. Often they're there because the aircraft's navigation system wants you to manually check or confirm a part of your route, especially when you're transitioning from one phase of the flight to another, like from the SID to an en route segment, or from a STAR to an approach. Think of a discontinuity as a way for the aircraft to say, "Hey, I need you to confirm that this is what you want to do." It's a safe measure to make sure the aircraft doesn't suddenly jump from one waypoint to another in an unexpected way. To remove a discontinuity, simply click on Clear, then the discontinuity, then Insert. This action connects the waypoints, removing the gap. Always double check after removing a discontinuity to make sure your flight plan flows smoothly. Now let's move on to one of the most critical parts of your pre-flight setup, calculating your V-speeds. V-speeds are the specific speeds you'll use during takeoff, and they're crucial for a safe departure. The Fenix A320 family comes equipped with an EFB or an electronic flight bag, which makes calculating these speeds quite easy. To calculate your V-speeds, open the EFB and navigate to the performance calculation page. Here, you'll enter your details like your takeoff weight, the runway you're using, the weather conditions, and whether you're using flaps. These inputs help the EFB calculate the optimal speeds for your takeoff. For example, enter your takeoff weight, runway, and flap setting. The EFB will then calculate V1, VR, and V2. These are your decision speed, rotation speed, and safety speed, respectively. These speeds ensure that you have enough runway to safely abort or continue the takeoff. Once the EFB provides the V-speeds, you have two options. You can manually enter them into the MCDU, or even better, use the EFB's convenient Add to MCDU button. Simply click Add to MCDU, and your V-speeds will be automatically transferred to the MCDU, saving you time and ensuring accuracy. This seamless integration between the EFB and the MCDU makes your pre-flight setup faster and more efficient, letting you focus on flying rather than data entry. With all the information entered, your MCDU is now fully configured for the flight. Take a moment to review each page, ensuring all data is correct. The MCDU will now manage your flight from takeoff to landing, guiding you through the entire journey. Thanks to SimBrief integration, the Fenix EFB, and your MCDU setup, you've ensured that your flight plan and performance data are accurate and realistic. Now you're ready for pushback and engine start. Enjoy your flight, and remember, practice makes perfect. The more you use the MCDU and EFB, the more intuitive it'll become. Thanks for joining me for this comprehensive tutorial on setting up the MCDU in the Fenix A320 family. With SimBrief integration, EFB V-speed calculation, passenger and fuel loading, descent wind entry, nav data checks, and handling those tricky in-flight changes and discontinuities. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so that you never miss an update. Fly safe, and I'll see you in this next video.